Greetings. In the world today, the evil cancer of Islam is spreading. One fraud used in Islam to whip up the fire ants of Mohammed is the claim that Islam has rights to the city of Jerusalem. Did you know Jerusalem was never visited by Mohammed? Stated another way, Mohammed never went to Jerusalem. Did you know Jerusalem is not even mentioned in the Quran? That's right, the word Jerusalem never appears in the Quran. It is nothing but a modern insertion into the quote-unquote unchangeable Quran. There is one verse Islam desperately twists to try and imagine a mention of Jerusalem. Surah 17:1. Islam calls this the night journey of Muhammad. I call it a load of cow manure. Let's look at it and see why. 17:1, the Assad translation. Limitless in his glory is he who transported his servant by night from the inviolable house of worship to the remote house of worship, the environs of which he had blessed, so that we might show him some of our symbols. For verily he alone is all hearing and all seeing. This text, in brackets, is inserted by translators at Mecca and at Jerusalem. It does not appear in the Arabic language of the Quran. Notice, neither Mecca nor Jerusalem actually appears in the Arabic. If you've never heard it, let me be the first to tell you. Only the Arabic Quran is really the words of Allah. I know, it always makes me laugh that Allah can only speak Arabic. But keep this in mind, the author of the Quran never used the word or name Jerusalem. Now, to keep this reasonable, I am only going to cite the phrase pertinent to Muhammad's destination. Pickthall. From the inviolable place of worship to the far distant place of worship. Shakir, from the sacred mosque to the remote mosque. Ali, the sacred mosque to the farthest mosque. Lalay, from the Masjid al-Haram to the Masjid al-Aqsa. Now this is actually a more faithful translation. But if you are not wise, you will fall for the deception of Islam. See, Texas, it says the Al-Aqsa Mosque, which is in Jerusalem. And that is the deception in full view. Yes, a mosque called Al-Aqsa Mosque is now in Jerusalem. Now, but not before it was built in 700 AD. Yes, Muhammad made up his imaginary journey to some mosque he called Al-Aqsa. You can even verify this in the transliteration of the Quran. Mina al-Masjidi al-Harami ila al-Masjidi al-Aqsa. And that is the deception in full view. There was no mosque in Jerusalem called Al-Aqsa, not until an Islamic leader came after Muhammad died and built it. From the Masjid al-Haram to Masjid al-Aqsa, a place that did not even exist yet. Khan, from the sacred place of worship to the remote house of worship. More translator-inserted text in brackets. Irving, from the hallowed mosque to the further mosque. Muntakab, from the sacrosanct mosque, Mecca, to the furthest mosque, Jerusalem. Not even any brackets by Muntakab, he just inserts Jerusalem. Progressive, from the restricted temple to the most distant temple. Halim, from the sacred place of worship to the furthest place of worship. Daryabadi, from the sacred mosque to the furthest mosque. Ahmed Ali, from the sacred mosque at Makkah to the distant mosque. Buli, from the Masjid al-Haram to the Masjid al-Aqsa. I wanted to show this many to you so you may see several things. 1. Jerusalem is not actually mentioned in the Quran. 2. Islam does not care what the Quran actually says. This ayat is close enough to twist into the lie that Islam needs. 3. Never believe what Islam says the Quran says. I was having this argument with a young Mohammedan recently, and his story changed several times. First, he began by claiming, "Yes, no one said there's a mosque built when Mohammed flew the night journey. He stood on rock, and so Muslims build a mosque around the rock for such great event." I replied with, "Your statement is false, brother. Surah 17:1, Ali translation, who did take his servant from the night journey by night from the sacred mosque to the furthest mosque. Note, furthest mosque, not rock. Asad, to the remote house of worship, not a rock. Khan, to the remote house of worship at Jerusalem. Irving, from the hallowed mosque to the furthest mosque. The Omar, from the holy mosque at Makkah to the distant mosque at Jerusalem. The Quran, written by Muhammad, makes the claim of a mosque, brother." And after several more messages proving there was no mosque at Al-Aqsa during Muhammad's life, he replied, "If it the Quran says there's a mosque, then there was a mosque." But if you notice, he started out saying there was a rock. And the basic problem with that form of thinking is that it ignores reality. Even if you choose to say, "Yes, the Quran says to a mosque, so Muhammad flew to a mosque," you must include reality and logically conclude that his imaginary night flight was to some other mosque, one that actually existed someplace other than just in Muhammad's imagination. And once reality filters in, it then becomes impossible to claim this Surah 17:1 mentions anything about Jerusalem. At least you Christians need to understand this about Islam. Someone from Islam is free to tell any lie they imagine in their effort to win a debate. Or more importantly, to them, to convince you by any means necessary to say Shahada. And all that is really around the central point. Islam has no legitimate right and no legitimate claim to Jerusalem. But they cannot really help themselves because God has made Jerusalem the center of the world. Ezekiel 5:5, "Thus says the Lord God, this is Jerusalem, I have set her at the center of the nations with lands around her." Zechariah 12:2, "Behold, I will make Jerusalem a cup of trembling unto all the people round about, when they shall be in the siege both against Judah and against Jerusalem." I believe many Christians misapply Daniel's prophecy of the 70 weeks, because they scan and gloss right over the very first words out of the angel's mouth. 70 weeks are determined upon thy people and upon thy holy city. Thy holy city means Jerusalem. This is another reason Islam is so desperate to take and control Jerusalem. Satan thinks he can interfere with the plan of God if he can destroy Jerusalem. So watch with keen interest what transpires in Jerusalem. And Sha'alu Shalom Yerushalayim. Pray for the peace of Jerusalem. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.